All right, trying to figure this thing out still. Using the Insta360. I'm curious how the audio is and video is. It's a little bit overcast. It's getting late in the day, so it may be too dark out to really get the best images, but we're gonna see. You can hear my damn chain rubbing against the tire. Yes, I said tire. But I've been struggling dealing with that all week. We'll get to that. Let's get a little warm up in here. Just a little bit. Always got to be careful going around the trails first time for the day, because there would be stuff like that and all that. There ain't no way this thing's gonna be stable. There's a rabbit. With it being on my handlebars, but we'll see. I will be impressed. Got my X9000 coming next week. Supposedly. I think this is moving. Yes, sir, it is. While we're moving it, let's go ahead and do this. Let's just put it right here. And tighten the bee's knees out of it. There's got to be a better way to get these tight, because, oh, that might be on there. We'll see. We adjusted the camera a little bit. Man, spider webs. Definitely getting kind of dark back here. I'm curious to see how this does. I'm on 8K, 30 frames per second. Curious if you can see the hills. Better than a GoPro. My back pads are shot, so I pretty much only have the front. think my pads come in tomorrow. Oh man, I have so much to talk to y'all about. Woo. Crazy old house. Someone probably had a great life living there. And just left for nothing. Curious to see how this gonna look. Man, that tire rubbing. I'm beginning to wonder if this jack shaft's messed up. I guess. Wasting daylight. It's stinking. super rough. Getting tree branches all over my face. Crap. Oh, spider. Spider. That brick is gone. Tire pressure is a little too high. That was cool. I knew I'd see some. Didn't think I'd get lucky enough to see two. Sounds like I got a flat tire riding on these pine cones and pine straw. best, not the worst. Go back here to my infamous 90-foot tabletop. Camera move too. All right, so let's talk about some things. Get y'all off the handlebars. It's not too bad. All right, so first things first, these are Warp 9 wheels that last week I hit that jump, and you see I'm kind of flat landing it, but they got so bent out of shape. I'm talking about ridiculously. So what we did, or what I tried to do, was true them up. Still had a little bit of wobble in it, couldn't fix it. Wound up taking it to my mechanic. He was able to true it. So I guess they're fixed, but, you know, 2-week-old wheels, I wasn't expecting that to happen. I know it's probably my fault, but I was hoping for a little better quality. So when I put it back on, it was rubbing on the tire extremely bad. So I went in and shaved off this whole knob on the right side, and it's still almost hitting. And I talked to my mechanic about that. I mean, it is hitting a little bit, but not near as bad as it was. A little somewhat straight, still curving it, whatever. Okay, so I've been fighting with that for a week. Just really annoyed me. Paid way too much for these wheels. Needless to say, I will not be getting another set of Warp 9 wheels at the moment. My battery lid is pretty loose. Was told to put some padding in there on that. Got a little ripper coming. Another ripper. So another thing, like, remember how I used to talk about a little squeal at like 8 miles an hour? Well, I found out my belt was extremely tight. Now there's no more squeal of the belt, and it's actually loose enough. I think that's good. But I'm wondering if I, in that whole process with the chain rubbing and just being too tight, if I messed up the jack shaft. You hear it's pretty loud in there. And I want to say I can see a wobble, but I'm not sure. My kid just ate it. You all right? My kid just ate it. See if it stays on that. Well, that's my rant for you guys. Bike is much quieter now with the chain loosened properly, but I still have, I think it's the jack shaft making that kind of like bag of rock sounding noise, like it's dirty or something. I'm gonna try to clean it up and see if it improves any. Yeah, still hear my damn, the loudest part is that jack shaft, man. And also my frame's still rubbing. But yeah, getting a little annoyed with all that, to be honest. But most of it's my fault, I guess. Yeah, I don't think it should be that loud. But before I was just hearing the belt. I couldn't really hear that. I don't know. Let me stop yapping and just ride while I got light. That?
What?
You hit that and clear it?
I just didn't notice there was I forgot there was a ditch there.
Oh, I thought you hit that.
Nah.
Oh damn, you alright?
Oh.
It also felt super robbed of power. Loving the suspension. That is probably my best upgrade besides the Fortnite risers and foot pegs. Like, I would not be able to be out here doing what I'm doing on the stock suspension. You're just feeling super uncomfortable. Still have a little bit more to go. All right. I'm tired. Long day of work. Long day of shaving off these damn knobs. See, I used to get it real bad. Squeal around 8 miles an hour. I can just hear the motor now. From that stupid jack shaft. I love the thing, don't get me wrong. You can still hear this after listening to all my yapping. I think I just expected a dirt bike. That's my mistake. It's not a dirt bike. It's an e-bike. But we're getting it to dirt bike level. yeah, I also, like an idiot, forgot to put the spacer on the front. So for a good while it was rubbing, which is why I still have front brakes and not back brakes. I'm an idiot, basically. It's easier to clear this thing this side, but the run up is so bad. Got a big ride Saturday, which is why I even decided to try a new camera. Stay tuned for that. Something don't feel right. Front end. I don't know if I'm feeling that. I doubt it. Latest to come. That tire rub. Hell no. Once again, I'm an idiot. Just have the kickstand up. Oh yeah, but back to the wheel. I think originally it came dished because it wasn't running, rubbing the chain on the tire. And then after I trued it, after it bent, then I think I pulled it back over to the right and then it started rubbing. And then it was just all out of whack. Still looks like it might be good though with this lighting. Yeah, it's getting pretty dark. Let's try something. So I changed the to be pretty much. I can go even more actually. Okay, so that's dead center with the wheel. We're up to 300 miles on the bike. It's all off-road. Catch him.